appreciate that. Well, welcome to Family Feud, Ghana. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Etisin, Ghana. Yeah. Right, yeah. Float with your money right. Get your money right, yeah. It was nothing. Didn't mean nothing. Just threw that in. And everybody in a good mood today?
Yes. Yeah.
This is gonna be really good, everybody. Welcome to Family Feud, Ghana style. This is the way the game works. We've had some researchers going out on the streets of Ghana asking you some answers to some really, really simple questions. Those answers to those questions are locked into the game board behind me. All your family has to do is guess what the answers are. The team that guesses the most and ends up with the most points will be playing for a grand jackpot prize of $5,000. So if you want to meet the family, everybody see yeah.
Yeah!
From Greater Accra, it's the GYE NYAME family. Playing against from Accra, it's the six MILUDU family. What the hell is going on?
You already know.
Obviously,
you know.
There's something I need to know.
They know.
Because this was crazy just now.
Look at us, Steve.
Well, we're about to find out. If you're ready for the show to get started, everybody see yeah.
Yeah!
All right, give me Emma K, give me Dino.
Salut.
Yeah? I might not know who they are, but I damn sure gonna find out who you are. Emma K.
Yeah.
My man.
Yeah.
Moonwalk, turn, spun, pop. Ow. Yeah, we're gonna have some fun today. Yeah.
You know, bro?
All right. Top 7 answers on the board. Welcome to the show, fellas.
Thank you, Steve.
Here we go. Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
Sneakers.
Sneakers.
You playing, Steve? You playing? You playing?
Let's go. Well, about to find out what all this damn Holland's about.
Hey.
Dino, my man, how you doing?
Doing good, doing good.
What do you do, sir?
I'm an actor, Steve.
Oh, okay. Oh, we get it. What's one of the projects you've acted on?
Couple TV series.
Oh, okay.
Couple movies.
Oh, that's what? Oh. Well, I'll tell you what, before I get too deep in this, why don't you introduce everybody?
Okay, Steve, yeah. Well, this is Yamfo, my brother from another mother.
Uh-huh.
That's Elam, my other brother from another mother. And that's Sammy, my other brother from another mother.
You tell them. Yonfo?
Yes,
Yonfo. What do you do, sir?
I run a social media agency.
I run a social media agency. And in this social media agency, I use this voice that I'm using
yes.
now.
Yeah, exactly.
It's a radio voice. That's I talk voice. To people. I am the voice of moisture. When I'm talking, rain falls from the sky. When I'm talking, perspiration comes from under the arms. When I'm talking, there will be a lot. So that's good, man.
You're
welcome
right.
to the show.
Thank you very much.
How are you? You married? Single? You married?
I am married, yes.
Yes, you're married. Yeah, I can tell. You got a wedding ring on. What? Oh!
You
Steve. IBW, you're supposed to be happy. He's married. Oh, hell no. You're supposed to be happy. Now, let's change that. So, you are married?
I am married, yes, Steve.
Only for 2 weeks, though.
I've been married for 2 weeks.
You've been married for 2 weeks?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Oh, what, that changed it for y'all? 2 weeks? Oh, hell, girl. Hey, young girl. All right, let's go, man. Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
Steve, I would say clothes.
Clothes.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good job. Good job. Good job.
All right, let's go. Alone.
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 What the hell? What the hell is going on? Me. What the hell is going on here? Alone, what do you do?
I'm a business consultant.
Oh, business consultant. Hello, let me ask you a question, man. You married?
Engaged.
Oh, don't try to act happy now. We engaged. Yes. All right, man, let's play. Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
A ring, gold ring.
A fake ring.
Good at going.
Yes. Only one strike. Sammy.
Yes.
How are you, brother?
I'm great. How are you?
Good, good. What do you do?
I'm into social media marketing as well, so we run the same agency.
Oh, okay. That's good. That's good. All right, brother, let's go. Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
I'm going to go with fragrance. So, like, cologne, perfume, anything like that.
All right, Dino, don't worry about that. We got two strikes. We got to be careful.
Yes, sir.
Because the other family can steal. Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
Hair. Yeah.
Before I turn this answer over, I would like to make a statement about fake hair. I do not have a problem with it at all. As long as you look good in it, put it on, bring it on. That's it. I like natural hair, too. I like women who wear their hair natural, short. It's beautiful. By the way, Miss Universe is from South Africa, and that girl right there. Woo! 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 Hair! Come on!
That's the demon. That's the demon. That's the demon.
Young folk,
yeah.
Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
I had a friend that used to wear a fake watch, so I go with a watch.
Fake watch. Whoa. Hello, we got two strikes. Other family can steal.
Let's go along.
Name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
Let's go with sunglasses.
Okay. Sunglasses.
Good answer. Okay. Good answer. Good answer.
All right, pants, come on. My man, MK, name something people wear, but it's probably fake.
All right, Steve, I'm going to go with belt.
Good answer. Four.
Eyelashes.
Well, here we go, folks. GYME, not on the board. Six MILUDU got 59. Don't go away. We'll be right back. We're playing Family Feud, everybody. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. the GYE NYAME. Six MILUDU got 59. Give me Susan, give me Yonfo. Top six answers on the board. Name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
My bedroom.
Good answer, good answer.
Good answer. I tell you what.
Good answer.
Better not come in my bedroom. I'm ass naked. In the bedroom.
Well, Steve, I'm gonna go away. Church.
Church?
Yes. Yes.
Naked, found naked at the church.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Emma Kay, what do you do?
I'm an actor and a freelance entrepreneur.
Okay, why don't you introduce everybody?
I missed that.
You missed what I said.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I told you I mix up the languages. There's several languages in Ghana that you can choose from. Twi, you can speak Ga, or you can speak Pidgin. There are others, but I specialize in all three. So when I'm talking, I mix all three. In the same sentence. That way, I'm talking to everybody. So you have to pay attention. Oh, yeah, you. I mean, you can say it.
Yeah.
Want to introduce.
Okay.
As on the on element on the down there. And all the way on you are going there, there's Susan, and then go guy you Google, and then you know, all the answer go Leo.
Okay, so before I introduce them.
I didn't ask you for it before. You are not listening. What are you, Twi? You speak Twi?
I speak Twi.
Yeah, see, I knew. See, you're not listening. This is Pidgin, Twi, and Ga.
Okay.
Okay, you go before.
Okay, so before I introduce them, we have a surprise for you.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay, that's nice.
So don't mind the voice. Yeah. You know, we're just going to have fun.
Okay,
all right. Leo, can we have you?
Today's a special day.
Today's a special day, Steve Harvey.
A day to mark your birth.
A day to mark your birth, yeah.
Today's a special day. A day to mark your birth.
A day to mark your birth.
A day to sing and rejoice.
Happy birthday.
Bless you,
huh?
In all that you do.
That was good, man. I appreciate that.
May the good Lord bless you with long life.
Yes.
To 104, as you
pray. 104?
Yeah.
All I need is 41 more years.
41.
41. I'll be 104. I'm gonna push the chips up to the window. I'm gonna go home. I'm gonna see the king. Mm. I'm gonna be 104. That's all I asked for. Now.
Oh, give it up.
Now, the reason I want to live for 41 more years is because I have some money. I want to spend it. I don't want to leave none of it. Nobody gonna be at my funeral talking about, oh my God, what are we gonna get? Nothing. Steve and Marjorie spent it all. I'm living my best life. Hey.
Yeah. You got your side, guy. Yeah. That's what's up.
Yeah. All right, go ahead.
There's Yakubu. And then we have Leo.
Hey, Leo.
Yes.
Okay, welcome to the show. Now,
thank
Yakubu,
you.
What do you do?
I am an actor and also a potential makeup artist.
So when you say you're a potential makeup artist, that means you don't really know how to put the makeup on yet?
I'm learning.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good. There you go. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
The lorry station.
The what?
Lorry station.
The lorry. The lorry station. Hey, Leo.
Hi,
how
Steve.
Are you?
All I'm right. Fine.
What do you do?
I'm a performing arts practitioner. Mm-hmm. I am a model and a beauty queen.
You better be fine, girl. You know, Leo, when I came down here, I said, Leo, show is fine. I am a model, a practitioner. Okay, you married?
No.
No? Take care. Uncle Steve got this. Don't worry about this. I got you.
Sure.
Name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
I think, Steve, I don't want to be found naked at my workplace.
At the workplace. MK, name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
In a marketplace.
In the marketplace. Susan?
Hi, Steve.
Oh, God. Okay, this is a fun question. We're
yes,
having
Steve?
Fun. Name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
I don't want to be found naked at where I school. Yeah. Yeah. Good answer.
Oh, at the school.
Yay.
At the school. Yakubu, name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
I don't want to be found naked at the airports.
Standing there with all that luggage in your hand. Say, man, why don't you open that luggage and put some of them damn clothes on? I was in a hurry. I could not finish packing. At the airport. All right, Leo, we got a problem now. We got two strikes. We got to be careful.
Okay.
Six MILUDU can steal. Name a place where you would not want to be found naked.
At a party.
At a party.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Brothers, name a place where you not want to be found naked.
On the internet, Steve.
That's a good answer, too.
Good answer. Yeah. Good
answer. On the internet. Number five.
In someone else's room.
Number two.
On the street.
Well, that's round two, everybody. And boy, oh boy, oh boy, we got a game now, folks. Get down that family got 58. Six MILUDU got 59. It's close. Don't go away. We're after the break. We're going to be playing for double the points. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. We got a close one today. Jinyawe family got 58, Six MILUDU family got 59. Gimme Yakubu, gimme LO. Yeah, got the little sparkle pants.
Thank you.
Got to find them right there. I wear them, I gotta lose a little weight though. Put them on, they'll look like panties. Now, really, if you see something that look good on somebody else, that don't mean you should go buy that. Just cause it's in style don't mean it's in style for you. See these little tight pants, skinny jeans? You know why? Cause he's skinny. I put them jeans on. Damn, Steve. All right, let's go, fellas. In this round, we've doubled the points. Top six answers on the board. Name a noise an animal makes.
Moo.
Woof. Woof.
No, no. That's a bark, baby. Bark!
Let's go.
Sammy,
yes.
Name a noise an animal makes.
Nah.
Hey, Sammy.
Mm-hmm.
Sam, I ain't hear you.
Nah. This server is fake.
Dino.
What's up, Steve?
Give me a noise that an animal makes.
Meow.
One more time, Dino.
Meow.
That's a great answer, Dino.
The little sick cat, meow.
Woo!
I love that cat, man.
Young folk, I love that cat. Yeah,
that
boy.
Cat,
young folk, hey, man, make a noise that an animal makes.
It's up there.
It's up there. One more time. Obviously, I haven't been in Africa that long. Something is happening here. I have no... What did you do?
That's a chicken, man.
That's a sick ass chicken. You don't want to eat this chicken. Eat this chicken, that's salmonella. All right, hello, man. Good job, fellas. One strike. Name a noise that an animal makes.
A bird. That's a good bird. Bird tweets.
What did you just do? When a girl walked by?
No, that's the sound a bird makes.
Oh, sound a bird makes?
Yes.
Yes.
Close.
That's the bird part.
Not in Ghana. Not in Ghana. Our birds are different.
Okay, well, we got different birds. Damn it, that's a bird. The sound that a bird makes. All right, we got two strikes, Sammy. We got to be careful, man. The other family could steal. Give me a noise that an animal makes. You know what that is.
Good answer. It's up there.
The reason, yes. The reason we are in this mess that we are in today was because of a snake. Wasn't that snake, we'd have been okay. Snake slithered right on up and talked to that girl. God, dog. We wouldn't be having no problems. We'd be in the garden eating, chilling. Everybody have money, plenty to eat, boats. But oh no, here come that snake. Dino, listen to me. We got two strikes, so we have to be careful here. If it's not there, the other family can steal, okay? Name a noise that an animal makes.
Yeah. again.
No, Dino. Hey, Dino. See, look, man.
What's up?
See, what you did was you didn't like the first part, but you enjoyed the second part. Yeah, see, that's the part you want to do. But you didn't. You wanted to do that, and then you hurry up and got to the. So let's do the whole thing again. Put them together, Dino. Let's go. Name a noise that an animal wakes.
Woo woo, dog.
That's a mosquito.
That's a mosquito.
Yeah, mosquito.
Dog. Good answer. Come on, dog.
Mosquito. Six. How y'all miss that, man? The whole world comes here to see that.
Yes.
There is no wildlife like on the continent of Africa. There's no place like it on Earth. I don't care where you go. You cannot see what you see here. Roar, the lion, king of the jungle. You come to Africa, this is the real deal. Yeah. Well, I need both families' attention right now because this is our last round and both of you have everything to play for because this is it. No matter what the score right now, this will decide. Whoever gets the answer and wins the points at the end of this round will be playing for the jackpot of $5,000. As it sits, GYE NYAME family 58, 6 MILUDU family 227. So let's get it on. Give me Leo, give me Sami. I need them right there, man.
I got you, bro.
I need that right there.
I got you.
That's player. Top five answers on the board. In this round, point values have been triple. This will decide the game. Here we go. Name something a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
A lunchbox.
Lunchbox.
Okay.
We're playing, come on. We're playing, let's go, baby. You got it. Dino.
Yes, sir.
Name something a six-year-old would take on the first day of school.
Pencil, Steve.
Pencil. Young folk.
Yep.
Name something a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
They'll take their school bags.
Take their school bags.
Let's go, boy. Let's go, boy. Good answer. Good answer.
And name something that a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
Change of clothes.
A change of clothes. So when they pee on themselves, a change of clothes. He's going to pee on himself. Oh. Only one strike, Sammy. We are rolling. Name something a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
A book.
A book.
For the money, Dino.
Dino.
For the money, Dino.
Here's the situation, man. There's only one answer left, one answer only. You only have one strike. If it's there, your team wins the game, your team will be playing for $5,000. If it's not there, you're still alive, only one strike. Dino, name something a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
I'd say money, Steve.
You got to have money. You gotta have money. Young folk, two strikes. Let's go. Name something a six-year-old would take on their first day of school.
They might take a toy.
Take For the win, a toy.
Come on.
Great family, y'all played good. Y'all played really good. Y'all played really good. Hope y'all had a good time. Well, listen, you played well, you won't go away empty-handed. You walked away with $290. Well done. All right, fellas, I need 200. Come on, man, I got you. I'll take care of that, don't worry about that. I got Yalco, I got Dino. We gonna play fast money, $5,000. Me and the fellas, right after this, yeah. All right, everybody, welcome back to The Feud. Six MILUDU won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
All right, young folks, here's how the Fast Money works. Dino is off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. If you and Dino come up with 200 points, look right there, tell them what you're gonna win.
$5,000! Come on, win this money.
Well, yeah, that was extra. All right, you ready?
Ready.
Oh, 20 ready. Seconds on the clock, please. Okay. Clock will start after I read the first question. Come on, man, let's go. Name something parents tell their children not to waste.
Food.
A body part you stretch.
Legs.
Seafood people order at a restaurant.
Shrimp.
A word that starts with hyper.
Hyperinflation.
Something that smells bad.
Feet.
All right, let's go, baby. All right, let's see how we did. Name something parents tell their children not to waste. You said food. Survey said? A body part that you stretch. You said stretch your legs. Survey said? Seafood people order at a restaurant. You said shrimp. Survey said? Yeah. A word that starts with hyper. You said hyperinflation. Survey said? Something that smells bad. You said feet. Survey said? All right, there we go. All right, now let's bring out Dino.
Here we go.
All right, Dino, now. Got some pretty good news for you, man.
Talk to me, Steve.
Yeah, your boy came through for you.
That's Yamfo.
Yamfo, yeah, Yamfo got 110 points.
Let's go.
Yeah. You need 90 points to win the $5,000. Now, Dino, listen to me, man. We got to focus, okay?
Yes, sir.
It's hard to get 90 points in the second position.
Sure.
So I need for you to focus, okay? Yes. That's how we're gonna do it. I'm gonna ask you the same 5 questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're gonna hear this sound. I'm gonna say try again, you give me another answer. All right?
Yes, sir.
It's going to be a little bit tougher this time, so we're going to give you 25 seconds. You ready?
Yes.
All right. Let's remind everybody of Yamfo's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name something parents tell their children not to waste.
Time.
A body part you stretch.
Your arms.
Seafood people order at a restaurant.
Fish.
A word that starts with hyper.
Hyperventilate.
Something that smells bad.
Your breath.
Come on, Dino. All right, let's go, Dino. Come on, baby. All right, let's see how we go, my man. All right, brother, let's go. We need 90 points. Name something parents tell their children not to waste. You said time. Survey said?
Sounds good.
Number one answer was food. Food was the number one answer. 88 points away. A body part you stretch. You said arms. Survey said.
Boom. Come on, D-Man. Come on.
Number one answer, arms. Seafood. People order at a restaurant. You said fish. Survey said. Oh.
We're doing this.
Number one answer, fish. We need 17 points. A word that starts with hyper, you said hyperventilate. Survey said hyperactive was the number one answer. We need 17 points. Something that smells bad. You said breath. Survey said.
Well, I thought you had that.
I ain't gonna lie to you, man. Wow. Well, they scored. Let me get them straight. Hey, fella, just so you know, hey, come here, so you be straight, come here. Come here, fellas, listen to me. Because of your points and the number of points you scored 183 points. We triple that, you walk out with a grand total of $5,200. Yeah. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks.